We continue now at the top of Daf Lamed Amud Aleph and Meseches Megillah. This is Megillah Daf 30a. And the previous Amud, the Gemara had asked, what happens if you have a situation where the Parsha of Shkolim, which is read from Kisisa, falls out, the Parsha of Hashavua happens to be Tetzaveh. Now the issue over here is that Tetzaveh is right before Kisisa. So it ends up that what you're laning is you're going to lane the Parsha of Tetzaveh, and then for the Parsha of Shkolim, you're going to lane the very next Parsha of Kisisa. So that's what the Gemara suggested, but now Abaya doesn't like that suggestion, and he argues as follows. He says, Amri, people are going to say ukmahu dekamuk mihasam. People are going to say that they just made a mistake. They ended up just, they kept reading into the next parsha by mistake. They're not going to realize that they're reading from Parsha Shkolim. Rashi over here says, Amri ukmahu dekamuk mihasam kolomar ein adavar nikar l'shem Parsha Shkolim. It's not clear that you're reading this because of Parsha Shkolim. Elosavri shalun istayma parshas v'ata tetzava ad kan. People will think that parshas tetzava doesn't end until here because you're basically reading straight in the Sefer Torah. So Elo Amar Abaya. So rather Abaya says, Karu Shisa Miviatot Tetzave Adviosisa. What you do is you call up six people, six aliyas from Tetzave all the way through Viosisa, meaning including the Parsha of Shkolim, including that beginning of Kisisa. Vechad Tani Vekari Michitisa Adviosisa. And then somebody else will repeat and say again the beginning of Parsha's Kisisa. They'll say that Parsha, the Parsha of Shkolim. As Rashi over here says, Tani Vikari, Choser Vishona Likros, Michisisa Adviosisa Kirnechosha, someone will repeat it, then it's clear that it's being done for the Parsha Shkolim. And the Gemara continues, Meitzvah, we have the following question. Cholios beParsha Hasmuchola. We said, let's say it turns out that Parsha Shkolim falls out on the Parsha right next to Kisisa, like we said. Either it falls out on Tetzava or falls out the Parsha right after. Bein Milfana, Bein Milachar, it doesn't matter if it falls out the week before Kisisa, the week after Kisisa, doesn't make a difference. Korinosa, Vikoflinosa, you read it and you repeat it. So what exactly does that mean? So Bishlam Alei Abaye Nicha, according to Abaye, it makes a lot of sense what this means. It means what we just said. It means that what you're going to do is, let's say it's by Tetzaveh, you're going to read all the way through the beginning of Kisisa, and then Kovlosa, you're going to repeat it. You're going to repeat the Parsha Shkolim, that beginning of Parsha's Kisisa. Ela L'Rabbi Yitzchak Nafcha Kasha, but according to Rabbi Yitzchak Nafcha, that's not what you do at all. What you do is you just read it, and your last Aliyah is from Parsha's Kisisa. So where's the repetition? So how is he going to explain this braisa? So the Gemara says, Amar loch, Rav Yitzchak Nafcha. Rav Yitzchak Nafcha will respond to you very simply. Uli Abaya Minicha. According to Abaya, this braisa makes perfect sense. It's not true. Tenach lefana. I understand if you're talking about a situation where it falls out, Parsha Tetzave, the week before. So if Parsha Shkolim falls out in the Parsha Shavua, that's the week before Kisisa, you're repeating the beginning of Kisisa. But liacharea hechim ashkachasla. But if it falls out liacharea, meaning if it turns out a situation where Parsha Shkolim falls out the week after Parsha's Kisisa, that has nothing to do with what Abaya said. What does it mean over here that you're repeating? Elamayis lachlamemer. But what are you going to say? What does it have to mean? Kofla b'shabasas. Obviously, the brisa doesn't mean you're going to repeat it when you're laning today on Parsha Shkolim. What it means is you're going to lane from Kisisa 2 weeks in a row. You're going to have number one. You're going to lane Parsha's Kisisa because that's the Parsha Shavua, and then either the week before or the week after. If it turns out that that's Parsha Shkolim, you're going to repeat it the week before or the week after. And Hachanami Kofla B'Shabbosus, that's exactly what it means over here. It simply means you're going to repeat it two Shabbos in a row. You're going to lane from Kisisa. And the Gemara continues, Cholios B'Chisisa Atzma. Now what happens if Parsha Shkolim falls out on Parsha's Kisisa? So Amar Rabbi Yitzchak Nafcha says, Karu Shisa Min V'Yosisa Ad Vayakel. What you do is you call up six people from V'Yosisa, meaning you're starting not from the beginning of Parsha's Kisisa, but you're starting from the end of Parsha Shkolim, so to speak. That's going to be your first aliyah until Vayakil, until the very next Parsha. V'chad kari michisisa ad v'yasisa. Then you go back to the beginning of the Parsha, and for Parsha Shkolim, you read from the beginning of Kisisa until v'yasisa. So maskif lo Abaya, so then Abaya asked on that, doesn't like that either. Hashta amri lemafreya hudakari. Now everyone's going to say, you're reading backwards. So Elo Amar Abaya, rather Abaya says, here's what you do. Karu Shisa ad Vayakel. You read six aliyahs until Vayakel, meaning you read the whole Parsha's Kisisa, break it up into six aliyahs. V'chad, Tani Vikari, Michisisa ad Viosisa. And then what you do is you repeat the beginning of the Parsha from Kisisa until Viosisa. You do that for the sake of Parsha Shkolim. And the Gemara says, Tanya Kivase di Abaya. We have a braisa that supports Abaya. Chol Lios Bechisisa Atzma. If it falls out on Parsha's Kisisa, Koronosa Vikoflanosa. You read it and you repeat it exactly like Abaya said. And the Gemara continues at the two dots. The Mishnah said, Cholios Besocha Shabbos. Let's say Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out during the week. It doesn't fall out on Shabbos. So Makdimin L'Shabbos Avra. So then the week before Rosh Chodesh Adar, that Shabbos before Rosh Chodesh Adar, that's when you're going to read Parsha Shkolim. Itmar, it was learned the following Machlokas Amoroi. Rosh Chodesh Adar Shecholios Be'erev Shabbos. What happens if Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out on Erev Shabbos, meaning Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out on Friday? What do you do in such a situation? Rav Omer Makdim, and Rav says the same thing that we said in the Mishnah. You do it the Shabbos before. So even though the very next day is going to be Shabbos, Rosh Chodesh Adar fell out on Friday, still, you do the Shabbos before. That's when you read Parsha Shkolim. Shmuel Amar Ma'achrin, but Shmuel says, no, you just read it the next day. Already Rosh Chodesh Adar is Friday, so just read it the very next day. You'll read the Parsha Shkolim. Rav Amar Makdim, and Rav says you're going to read it a little earlier, meaning the week before. The Imkain Batsri Luhu Yomei Shulchanos, because if you delay it, you have less days of the money changers being available. In other words, the whole point is you want to have a certain amount of time before the money changers go out, and so people can exchange the money properly, give the half shekel. You don't want that to be any shorter than it has to be. Ushmuel Amar Ma'achrin, and Shmuel says, no, just push it off till the next day. You'll read Parsha Shkolim on Shabbos right after Rosh Chodesh. Amar Loch, he'll say to you as follows: Sof Sof Chameser B'Mali Shabbos. And it doesn't merely make any difference because the 15th is going to be in this particular situation. If Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out on Friday, so when is the 15th of Adar going to fall out? It's also going to fall out on Friday. So the money changers aren't going to go out anyway on Friday. They won't come out on Friday. They're going to wait until Sunday anyway. Therefore, you might as well delay. You might as well read Parsha Shkolim on the day right after Rosh Chodesh and the Shabbos right after. And the Gemara continues, Tanan, we learned in our Mishnah, the Mishnah said if Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out during the week, Makdimin l'shaver, so then you read Parsha Shkolim on the Shabbos right before Rosh Chodesh Adar, u'mafsikin l'shabbos acheres, and then you take a break for the next Shabbos. You don't read any special Parsha. So my lav isn't that. How do we understand this Mishnah? Afilu be'erev Shabbos. The Mishnah means to say anytime Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out during the week, even if it's Friday, they don't make any distinctions between what day of the week. In all situations, it seems like you're going to move it earlier, and that would follow Rav. That would be a question against Shmuel. So the Gemara says no, besoch haShabbos dafka. When it says during the week, it means really in the middle of the week. But if it would really happen on Friday, it could be Shmuel is correct, and you read Parsha Shkolim the next day. Tashma, coming here, another proof. Ezu hi Shabbos Rishona. What is the first Shabbos of these Dalet Parshios? Kol shechol Rosh Chodesh Adar lios besocha. Any situation where Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out in the middle of the week, v'afilu be'erev Shabbos, and even on Erev Shabbos. So the Gemara says, my lav is not saying, is the Brisa not saying, afilu be'erev Shabbos, dumya detocha. It's comparing Erev Shabbos to any other time during the week. If Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out in the middle of the week, or even if it falls out in Erev Shabbos, that's the same thing. You're always going to do the same thing. And what are you going to do? Matocha Makdim, and after Erev Shabbos Makdim, and just like if it falls out in the middle of the week, you read it the Shabbos before Rosh Chodesh. So too, if it falls out in Erev Shabbos, you're going to read it the Shabbos before Rosh Chodesh. So Amar Shmuel says, no, you have to amend the Braisa, read it as follows. Bo, what it should say is not that Rosh Chodesh falls out lios besocha during the week, but it means if it falls out bo on Shabbos, and what the Braisa means to say is Erev Shabbos is the equivalent of Shabbos. If it falls out on Shabbos or Erev Shabbos, which is the same thing, so then you're going to read on that Shabbos, meaning if it falls out on Erev Shabbos, you're going to read like Shmuel says on the next day. V'chein tana devei Shmuel, this was also taught in the yeshiva of Shmuel, bo, they amended the Braisa that it should be bo, and not it's not Bisocha. And the Gemara says, Kitanoi, this machlokus between Rav and Shmuel is actually a machlokus tanoi. Misargin l'shabbosus, it says you're going to skip by Shabbos, meaning there's always going to be a break. There's going to be one situation where one Shabbos where you're not going to read a special parasha. Divrei Rav Yehuda Anasi, that's the opinion of Rav Yehuda Anasi. Rav Shimon ben Elazar, Omer Rav Shimon ben Elazar says, ain't misargin, there's no skipping. Amar Rav Shimon ben Elazar. Now Rav Shimon ben Elazar explains. When do we say there's no skipping? V'zman shecholios be'erev Shabbos, in a situation where Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out on Friday. Because in such a situation, according to Rav Shimon ben Elazar, you're going to read the following day on Shabbos. You're going to read already the second day of Adar. You're going to read Shkolim. And there's going to be no occasion to skip every single week. You're going to read something from the Dalet Parshios. Aval v'zman shecholios besocha Shabbos. But if it turns out that Rosh Chodesh falls out during the week, makdim v'kore mishabbos over, then already you're going to read a little earlier. You're going to read the Shabbos before. Even though it's Shvat, so in that situation, Rav Shimon ben Elazar is saying, you are going to end up taking a break. There's going to be a Shabbos that you're not going to read a special Parsha because you read earlier. You read the Shabbos before Rosh Chodesh Adar, so now the Shabbos after Rosh Chodesh Adar, you're not going to read any special Parsha. That was what Rabbi Shimon ben Elazar said. And Rabbi Yehuda Anasi was saying, no, that's not true. Misargin l'shabbosus, meaning even when it turns out that Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out on Friday, you're still going to read the Shabbos before, and therefore you are going to skip a week. So the machlokus between Rav and Shmuel is exactly the machlokus between Rabbi Yehuda Anasi and Rabbi Shimon ben Elazar. And the Gemara continues, Bishnia Zohar, it said in the Mishnah that on the second Shabbos they read Parsha Zohar. Itmar, it was learned the following machlokus amoroim. Purim Shecholios Be'erev Shabbos. Let's say Purim falls out on Friday. So Rav Omar Makdim and Parsha Zohar. Rav says in this case as well, you read Parsha Zohar on the Shabbos before. You always want to read it the Shabbos before Purim. The idea is that you should mention the fact that we destroy Amalek during the laning before you actually have the holiday of Purim. But Shmuel says, no, in this case, if Purim falls out on Friday, so then Ma'achrin, then you should read Parsha Zachar on the next day. You read it on Shabbos, which would be the 15th of Adar. Rav Amar Makadim, and Rav says you read it on the Shabbos before Kihechi Delo Tikdam Asiya LeZechir. You don't want the Asiya, meaning the actual day of Purim, you don't want that to come before the Zechira, the mentioning of the destruction of Amalek. Shmuel Amar, and Shmuel says, Ma'achar, and Shmuel says, no, you're going to read Parsha Zachar the next day on Shabbos. Amar Loch, because he'll say to you, Kevon De'ikom Mukafin De'avdi B'chamesar, since you have the walled cities which generally celebrate Purim on the 15th of Adar, so Asiya LeZechir, Ba'adi Hadodi Ko'asiyon, that's all happening on the same day, because the 15th of Adar in this particular year is falling out on Shabbos, and that's the very day that you're reading Parsha Zachar. The Gemara says, Tanan, we learned in our Mishnah, Bishniya Zachar, on the second week you read Parsha Zachar. So the Gemara now thinks, right now, as Rashi explains, the Gemara thinks we're going on a case when Rosh Chodesh Adar, the Mishnah had the case when Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out on Shabbos. So the Gemara says, Vakim Mikla Reish Yarcha B'Shabbos. If you have a situation where on the calendar Rosh Chodesh Adar is falling out on Shabbos, so Mikla Purim Berav Shabbos, on that type of a year, Purim actually does fall out on Friday. The Katani B'Shniya Zachar, and what does it say? It says on the second week, you're going to read Parsha Zachar. That would seem to indicate that when Purim falls out on Friday, you're actually going to read the Shabbos before. That's going to be the second week. The first Shabbos is going to be Rosh Chodesh Adar. That's when you're going to read Parsha Shkolim. And the second Shabbos, which is the Shabbos before Purim, you're going to read Parsha Zachar. So Amar a papa says, no, my shnia lahafsaka. What we mean over here is we don't mean the second Shabbos straight. We mean there is an interruption of a week, but it's the second time that you are going to be laning one of the special parshios. As Rashi over here says, shnia lahafsaka kilomar lava reishakoi. What he's answering is we're not going on the first case of the Mishnah where Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out on Shabbos. Ela seifakoi, the katani cholios pesocha Shabbos. We're talking about a situation when Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out during the week. Makdim in l'shavar. So then we said in such a situation, you're actually going to read Parsha Shkolim the Shabbos before Rosh Chodesh. Umafsikin l'Shabbos haba, and there actually is an interruption. There's a week where you read nothing. V'alokoy, and that's what's going on. V'yomer b'Shabbos shel achar afsaka, on the second week, meaning the Shabbos after the time that you interrupted. The Shabbos after the Shabbos where you did nothing, Korin Zachar, that's when you read Parsha Zachar. Uvesoch Shavua shel acharei yei Purim. And during the week right after, as in a normal case, it's going to be Purim. Purim is going to follow the recitation of Parsha Zachar. That's how Shmuel will understand the Mishnah. And the Gemara continues, Toshma, come in here, the following proof, Ezu Shabbos Shniyah, what is the second Shabbos, meaning what is that Shabbos that you're laning Parsha Zachar? Kol Shechol Purim Lios Besocha V'afilo B'Erev Shabbos. Any week where Purim falls out during that week, and even if Purim falls out on Erev Shabbos. And so the Gemara says, my love, is it not? Erev Shabbos, Dumya D'Tocha, similar proof as earlier in the Gemara, earlier in the Yomid, Erev Shabbos is the same as during the week. Whether Purim falls out in the middle of the week, or whether Purim falls out on Erev Shabbos, it's the same thing. Ma Socha Makdimen, Erev Shabbos Makdimen. Just like if Purim falls out in the middle of the week, you're going to read Parsha Zachar the Shabbos before Purim. So if it falls out on Friday, you're going to read Parsha Zachar the Shabbos before Purim. And the Gemara gives the same answer as it gave earlier. Amar Shmuel, Shmuel says, Bah. You have to read this Brice a little differently. It doesn't mean that Purim fell out Bisocha in the middle of the week. It means it fell out on Shabbos. That's what it's talking about. And Erev Shabbos is the same thing as Shabbos. As we said before, Erev Shabbos is the equivalent of Shabbos, and you're actually going to read it on the following day in a situation where Purim comes out on Erev Shabbos. You're going to read Zachar in the following day on Shabbos. V'chein Tana de Shmuel, and that was also taught in the Yeshiva Shmuel. Again, the same idea, but we're talking about when it falls out on Shabbos. Now, Chol Yos B'Shabbos Atzma, now the Gemara says, what happens if Purim falls out on Shabbos itself? So Amar Rav Huna says, L'divrei HaKol Ein Makdimin. In such a situation, there is no machlokas. Everybody agrees if Purim falls out on Shabbos, you lay in Parsha Zachar on that day on Shabbos. You don't do it the Shabbos before. Rav Nachman Amar Adayin Hi Machlokas. Rav Nachman says, no, it's still a machlokas between Rav and Shmuel. Even in this case, Rav will say you read it the Shabbos before, and Shmuel will say you read it on Shabbos. Itmar Nami was taught as well. Amar Bechia Barabo, Amar Rabbi Abba, Amar Rav. Rabbi Chia Barabba says, in the name of Rabbi Abba, in the name of Rav, Purim Shecholios B'Shabbos, if Purim falls out on Shabbos, Makdim V'Kori B'Shabbos She'Avra Zachar, this is Rav's opinion, that still you're going to read it earlier on the Shabbos before you're going to read Parsha Zachar, and then again, Purim will be on the next Shabbos. And the Gemara continues at the two dots, the Mishnah said, B'Shlishis Parah Aduma V'Chulu, it said that on the third Shabbos, that's when you read Parsha's Parah, Tana Rabban and the rabbis taught, Ezuhi Shabbos Shlishis, what is the third Shabbos? Kol Shesmucha L'Purim Yachare, it's the Shabbos right following Purim. Itmar, it was learned, Rabbi Chanino says, Shabbos Hasmucha L'Rosh Chodesh Nisan. It's the Shabbos that is closest to Rosh Chodesh Nisan. And the Gemara says, Velo Pligi, it's not really a machlokas. Ha de ikla Rosh Chodesh Nisan b'Shabbos. It depends. In one case, we're talking when Rosh Chodesh Nisan itself falls out on Shabbos. Ha de ikla b'emsa Shabbos. In another case, we're talking when Rosh Chodesh Nisan falls out in the middle of the week. Rashi over here says, Ezui Shabbos Shlishis, what is the third Shabbos? Shekorin bo Parsha Shlishis, again, where you're reading the third Parsha, Parsha's Para. Ha de ikla Rosh Chodesh Nisan b'yom HaShabbos. If Rosh Chodesh Nisan falls out on Shabbos, Shelo Hutzrach Lahakdim Parsha's HaChodesh L'Shabbos She'avra. In such a situation, Parsha's HaChodesh can be read on that day. Rosh Chodesh Nisan is on Shabbos, and you read Parsha's HaChodesh on that day, so you don't have to read the Shabbos before. So, Karina L'Shabbos She'avra Parah Aduma. So, in that situation, you're actually going to read on the Shabbos right before that. You're going to read the Parsha of Para Aduma, Kid Rabbi Acha, Rabbi Chanina. And that follows the opinion of Rabbi Acha, Rabbi Chanina. That's actually what we said over here was Rabbi Chama, Rabbi Chanina. Rabbi Chama, Rabbi Chanina says, again, you read it on the Shabbos, Hasmucho L'Rosh Chodesh Nisan, V'lo B'smucho L'Purim. You don't read it near Purim, you actually read it right before the Shabbos. That's Hasmucho again, L'Rosh Chodesh Nisan. L'Smuch Azhar As Temeim L'Pesach. The idea is that Parshas Para is all about being pure. We want that close to Pesach. Now, v'heichod d'chol Rosh Chodesh Nisan be'emtsa Shabbos. Now, if you have a situation where Rosh Chodesh Nisan falls out in the middle of the week, shotzrachnu likros parshas haChodesh b'Shabbos shelefana. Now, in that situation, you're going to have to read parshas haChodesh the Shabbos before Rosh Chodesh. So then, huskaknu lahakdim parshas para l'Shabbos shelifnei Shabbosu. So now, parshas para is going to have to be the Shabbos before that. Shehi smucho l'Purim achara. In such a situation, then it happens to be that it's the Shabbos right after Purim. So that's how you resolve what seemed to be a contradiction. It's not a contradiction at all. It just depends how the calendar works out. The Gemara continues at the two dots. Barvias, the four Shabbos Hachodesh Hazelachem. That's Parshas Hachodesh. Tana Rabban and the rabbis taught Rosh Chodesh Adar Shecholios B'Shabbos. If Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out on Shabbos, so then Korin Kisisa. Then you read Parshas Kisisa. Again, this is talking about Parshas Shkolim. Umaftirin B'Yehoyada, and you do the Haftorah of the section in the Navi again in Malachim of Yehoyada. Ve'ezu he Shabbos Rishon. And what is considered the first Shabbos? Kol Shechol Rosh Chodesh Adar Lios Pesach. Any situation where Rosh Chodesh Adar falls out during that week, v'afilu be'erev Shabbos, even on Erev Shabbos, we've discussed this previously on the Yomid. B'shniyah Zachar, then it says on the second week, that's when you read Parsha Zachar, u'maftirin pokadati, and the Haftorah by Parsha Zachar is pokadati. And pokadati is a reference to the section in Sefer Shmuel that addresses the destruction of Amalek. Ve'ezu hi Shabbos Shniyah, and what's considered the second Shabbos, kol shechol Purim, lios pesocha, v'afilu be'erev Shabbos. Any situation, any week rather, where Purim falls out during that week, even if it falls out on Erev Shabbos, again, that was addressed earlier in the Gemara. Rav interprets this price in one way, and Shmuel interprets it another way. B'shlishis, and what is the third week? Para Aduma, that's when you read Parshas Para. Umaftirin v'zarakti aleichem. The Haftorah is v'zarakti aleichem. That's from Yechezkel. That has to do with purification. Ve'ezui Shabbos Shlishis, and what's the third Shabbos? Kol shasmucho l'Purim mi'achareo. That is the Shabbos that comes right after Purim. Baravias, and the fourth Shabbos, HaChodesh HaZeh, that's Parshas HaChodesh. Umaftirin ko'amar Hashem Elokim Barishon Be'echad LaChodesh. The Haftorah also from Yechezkel talks about what they brought on the first day of Nisan, and we will continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Lamed Amud Beis.